Hi, I'm Stephanie Sloan, Technical Specialist Soil Science for PGG Wrightson. Today we're here in the Mighty Waikato on Ian's farm talking about soil testing. Soil testing in the spring is one of the key activities in the farmer's annual plan. One of the reasons for this is because it really sets you up for what you're planning on doing in the next 12 months on your farm. Today we're looking at soil testing for fodder beet for the winter. So what Ian wants to do on his farm is extend his lactation period and then have some winter feed for his animals in the winter months. The depth at which we soil sample is really dependent on the rooting zone of your crops. For example, if you look at a pasture and clover paddock, you're really only soil testing down to 7.5 centimetres. Whereas if you're looking at a cropping system, such as a brassica or fodder beet, which is what we're growing here on this farm today, then you really want to get down to 15 centimetres because that rooting zone goes a lot deeper than the pasture profile. When you look at a sampling area, such as the one behind us, you want to make sure that you get a representative of the entire paddock. So avoiding high urine spots, such as around troughs or in gateways, as well as avoiding hedgerows where the animals might shelter from, as well as old fence lines, as this can alter the history of your soil fertility, which can skew your results. The process from here is that we now send the soil samples away, where they will be analysed at Hill Laboratories in Hamilton. This usually takes up to 10 days based on the soil parameters that the local technical field rep has requested. Once the soil tests have been received, the local technical field rep will put together a fertiliser recommendation program based on the farmer's system requirements, which he will then head out and have a conversation around where you go from here. If you have any questions or queries, please feel free to contact the local PGG Wrightson store or your local technical field rep, or feel free to read our Rural Diary newsletter that hits your letterboxes monthly.